Hi students, coming to the next topic in the subject, design and analysis of algorithm is asymptotic notations. So what are these asymptotic notations? So then why we use this asymptotic notations in design and analysis of algorithm? Okay, if you want to develop a program, okay, suppose a program is there, if you want to develop a program, okay, so for that program you need some A program that is developed is based on upon the time it takes to complete that program, means the time that it takes to execute the program and the memory that it occupies in the program will be based on complexities. So if you take any program, means that program may be in different programming languages. So whatever the programming language, so this you call it as a formal language. So before proceeding to the formal language, first you have to develop informal language. An informal language is nothing but an algorithm. Algorithm is a step-by-step procedure. Okay, so you just simply call it as a blueprint. So this I already explained the starting of this subject. So an algorithm, before developing the programming language, first you have to take the algorithm. So the algorithm which gives the blueprint of this programming language. So this algorithm can be different algorithms will be there. Okay, different types of algorithms will be there. In the program. So the programmer has to select. The programmer means the user has to select which algorithm is best suited. So how we can say this algorithm is best and this algorithm is best? Okay, so this will be analyzed based on the time it takes to complete the procedure program. Okay, and the memory that it occupies for the program. Okay, so an algorithm can be, the best algorithm can be chosen based on the time and based on the memory. So the algorithm which takes less time, less memory can be selected as a best algorithm, and that will be implemented for writing the programming language. So that is a analysis of algorithm. So the goal of analysis of algorithm is to compare algorithm mainly in terms of running time, but also in terms of memory requirements, programmer efforts, everything has to be considered. So that based on that we can analyze the algorithm and we can select the best algorithm. Okay, so whatever the running time of an algorithm we have taken, that running time of an algorithm, let me write, running time of an algorithm depends on how long it takes a computer to run the lines of a code, of the algorithm. So the running time of an algorithm depends on how long it takes a computer to run the lines of a code of the algorithm. So this lines of a code of an algorithm depends upon the, speed of computer, programming language, compiler and translator that we are using for that particular programming language. Okay, so these all points has to be considered while you are implementing an algorithm. So whatever the, so far whatever we have taken, the binary search, linear search, everything will be a trial and error, means you are just checking which algorithm is suitable for that and which is having less time and which taking the less memory, like that. So this everything for algorithm it's changing. The running time of an algorithm is completely depends upon the that speed of the computer and the programming language that we are using and the compiler and translator, that everything. So based on these points, for system to system it is changing. Okay, so to overcome this, we are going for the asymptotic notations. So the asymptotic notations here is the main idea of analyzing to have a measure of efficiency of an algorithm that does not depend on machine constants, does not require any algorithms to be implemented, and also time taken by programs to be compared. Okay, it does not bother about that. Let me write that. Asymptotic notations. Asymptotic analysis. Let me first explain about asymptotic analysis. The main idea of asymptotic analysis is to have a measure of efficiency of algorithm. The main idea of asymptotic analysis is to have a measure of efficiency of algorithm that does not depend on machine constants. So whatever the machine that you are using, it does not depends on machine constants, and it does not require algorithm to be implemented. And time taken by program to compare. Time taken by programs to be compared. So this is about the asymptotic analysis. So what is an analyze the asymptotic. So whatever the notations you have taken, whatever the complexities you are calculating for the algorithm. So this asymptotic analysis does not depends upon machine constants, and it does not require any algorithm to be implemented, and also time taken by the programs to be also compared. Okay, so it does not bother about all those things. Now let me write what is an asymptotic notations. Asymptotic notations. It is a way to describe the behavior of a function. So whatever the function that we are taken from the program, so it is a way of describing the behavior of that function in the limit or without bounds. Okay, so it is a way to describe behavior of a function. Behavior in the sense, a behavior, it tells about the time it takes to complete the sequence of steps in a code in the program, in the function, and the memory that it occupies to store that function, like that. So it is a way to describe the behavior of a function in the limit, it is tell in the limit or without bounds. Without bounds. And here the running time of an algorithm as a function of input size and for large n. It's it depends upon the input size that we are giving. The running time, if the input size is increasing, the running time is also increases. So this is about the asymptotic notations. So in the next video, I'll explain about the different asymptotic notations that we have used, and what is the growth of the asymptotic notations. Thank you.